been all that attention to me for $200?
Shot.
Yo, don't fuck this up.
Open the drawer.
My name's Nesto Rea, and my film is called No Shots Fired, and it was birthed out of the incredible frustration that I've been having, along with, I know, so many people, you know, across the nation, with the violence that's been taking place between the police and the public, especially during traffic stops. We wanted to show a balance of what both sides are going through and possibly a solution.
Hey, I love you.
Love you too.
I love you. Have a good day.
You too, monster.
More than 40 officers have been killed on the job in gunfire this year, and the world will never forget the 5 brave police officers killed by a cowardly sniper during this protest in Dallas this summer.
We got shots fired!
All the shit we got in the car, man. This is all bad, man.
You got your quicker, yeah?
Driver! Roll down your window and show me your hand!
So show me
Driver!
Ignore everybody.
Ready?
Let's do it. Roll down your windows and show me your hand!
San Diego shooting during a traffic stop has left one police officer dead and another injured.
We are living in a war zone. It's not as easy as these people are making us think, that we just got some criminal-ass black kids with guns. It is not like that. We live in hell. We live in the gutter. By the time you get out your house, you strapped to protect yourself, because you're living in the same community that the police is carrying rifles and riot gear. Who do you think the police is using that against? We fighting the same villains that they fight in the street. But instead of them seeing us fighting villains in the street, we are villains.
Show me your hands!
What do I do, bro?
Let me see your ID.
Well, you want my ID or you want my hands up? What do you want?
Show me your hands!
Here's my ID!
The voice of Rakia Scott pleading with Charlotte police, telling them her husband is unarmed and has a brain injury.
He got out of his car, he walked back there so that they could comply, and obviously complying still gets you murdered, because that's what happened.
So far this year, 708 people have been shot and killed by police.
Are you okay?
Yeah.
Was it the same dream?
I don't want Sophia to grow up in a world like this.
Nor anybody else. We're alone now. Dad?
A manhunt in Memphis after a police officer is fatally shot during a traffic stop.
The deadly shooting in Charlotte coming just days after another one in Tulsa. Dash cam video showing this father walking back toward his truck, his arms up, moments before an officer shoots and kills him.
After the shooting on Tuesday, hundreds took to the streets in anger. They set fires and smashed police cars.
Two Hattiesburg, Mississippi police officers were shot to death during a traffic stop. 29-year-old Marvin Banks and 26-year-old Curtis Banks were charged in the Saturday evening shooting.
From the sky, you could see the battle between police and the crowds. Images that have grown all too familiar in a nation used to reacting to deadly police encounters.
I'm just afraid of what happens next.
You know what happens next? For the rest of your time as an officer, you're going to hand in your paperwork and it's going to say, during every traffic stop today, there were no shots fired.
Take that thing, park it right up next to the car.
Oh, like if you pull somebody over?
Yeah.
Like if you pull them over?
Exactly.
Yeah, you could probably have that, like loop around.
The feed on that, that's live feed.
Oh yeah, right now. Like you could be in your car going like this and knowing exactly what's happening. Wouldn't that be crazy?
Michael Pinkney is the director of the short film Gang Girl. The Gang Girl short film is about three teenage girls from the New York City area. They're trying to find jobs in New York City. So what they decide to do is to steal from other people so they can make money. But what they find out is that when you steal from other people, there's a big price to pay.
Of course, man, like, yo. D is mad cool, yo. You about to like talk to him, make this money and shit. You ready for this?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Yo, here we are.
Hey, yo, D. This is my homeboy, Jamal, yo.
What's up, man? Jamal from where?
Yo, he's from my block, man. He won't put in that work.
Yo, this is some grown man shit, though, B. You can handle this?
See, I'm ready to put in that work, man. Get some money, man.
All right, we gonna see if you built for this. Yo, get him out of here, B. All
right, man. Let's go.
Come on, man.
We getting it, you know that.
$200 in here.
Gimme. I'm gonna take this to D-Rock. Try and be cuffed up. First, I gotta give him the money, and then we'll see.
What about that chick, Kaya?
She crazy. She's trying to be his girl, too.
He don't treat her right.
He don't treat you right either. Yeah, well, we'll see. Let's go. Yo, I can't believe you kicked her like that. I was like, what?
You got your new iPhone.
She hype. Look at her shooting everything. What is that? Is it Apple or something?
Hey. What y'all doing? What y'all going? Yo, get that out of my face, all right? Chill.
What, you don't want to be in a movie?
Nah, just you.
Romantic. You seen D-Rock?
Yeah, here, Ron. What you want?
I got something for him.
What you got for him?
I said I got something for him.
Nah, yo. Come here. You totally don't even know. Listen, if you want to get to D-Rock, you got to go through me. And if you want to go through me, don't bring your lot-ass groupies, all right? Now, what you talking?
I snatched bread for D-Rock.
How much?
200.
200 what?
Dollars.
You want me to bring you to D-Rock for $200?
What of it?
Alright, yo. Come through. I want to see this.
Shanti, baby, what's up?
Hey, I went harder this time.
Oh, yeah? Yo, who that?
She's just a friend.
All right, what's up, what's up?
You never believe what she got you.
Oh, yeah?
200.
200, where you get that money from?
You beat this girl up.
Y'all beat some girl up for $200? Y'all bring all that attention to me for $200? And you brought them to me?
Yo, D, I told her.
Come on, it's something, right?
Forget that 200. I know we could get 2,000 for him.
What I gotta do?
Listen, come here. Listen, this is some grown woman shit, B. You think you can handle this? You sure you ready, ma? Get ready, it's going down tonight. All right?
Yo, D-Rock gave me the gun, I got the register.
So do we do.
You two look out and you be distraction.
We gotta have something for our faces.
That's what the hoodie's for, stupid.
Shanti, you gotta promise you won't shoot that guy.
That's not up to me, that's up to him.
Are you kidding me, Shanti? We could go to jail.
So what's it gonna be?
Do I have a choice?
Yeah, you do. Yo, don't fuck this up.
Advil, my friend here has a bad headache.
Oh, that's too bad. I think I have some.
Give me your money. Open your register before I shoot you.
Please, sir, just do what she says.
Yo, go in the drawer! Look, if you don't empty that drawer, I'm gonna pop him first and then I'm gonna pop you.
Chauncey!
Shut up! Look, China, give me your money.
Shanti, what the hell are you doing?
Yo, you open your mouth one more time, and I'm gonna pop you too.
How old are you?
Old enough to know how to point and shoot. Open your drawer.
This is a mistake. D-Rock won't understand.
Ain't nobody understanding anything. Yo, we dead either way.
No, we're not. We can talk to someone, or we could go to my parents.
Yo, this is not how shit works, Snow White.
Shoot me. I'm not doing this.
Look, I don't got much money here. Most of it I went out to deposit an hour ago.
Shanti, candy took off.
Mm-hmm. to our web series, Finding My Obama. I'm Jackie McKinley.
And I'm Antonia March, and we're the co-writers and co-directors of our web series. We are comedy writers who have recently made the transition into the world of drama.
So our web series, Finding My Obama, is about a woman's quest of finding the perfect man. And in her case, the perfect man is Barack Obama. Enjoy.
Enjoy.
I just feel like the Plan B pill is the best thing that happened since, like,
Sydney.
Okay.
You know what? You know what we need?
You're disgusting.
I'm responsible.
Yeah. Another round, please.
Please.
Because
Kyle, in order to hear this.
Shots.
Got his job on the line.
Shots, get the fuck out. They give you a liquor license to not pour him up.
Life.
Let's live.
Life in the Plan B on 3, won't you?
You're so ridiculous. Life.
Woo! That was good.
Another round, mon frere.
What's that? Did you say something?
Hey, sorry. Did I wake you, Xavier?
Oh, that's all right.
Nefertari.
That's right, Neff. How could I forget such a beautiful name?
That's a good question.
Well, I guess I better bounce, huh? Unless you're talking about hooking up some breakfast.
Oh, no. You go ahead and bounce. I'm sure you got a job to get to. What is it that you do again?
I'm a scientist.
Oh, what kind?
A freelance.
So you just walk around doing experiments?
Yeah, something like that.
Hmm, okay.
Well, I guess I better go. It's been fun, huh?
Good times!
Hey, you think you could float me a couple of dollars for the bus?
Ain't this a...
What?
Let me introduce myself. My name is Nefertari Taylor, but you can call me Neff for short. I'm originally from Chi-Town, but I live here in Los Angeles, and I'm an actress. I know you're saying, girl, everybody in Los Angeles is an actress. I know, right? But listen, here's my dilemma. Ever since college, I have not taken control of my life, especially when it comes to men. Like, I just let shit happen. If a man asks me out, I'm just gonna go on a date. Instead of going for what it is that I really want in my life. And right now, what I really want in my life is to find my own Obama. No, not the real Obama, but a man that has his characteristics and his qualities. You know what I'm saying? Let me show you what I'm talking about.
All right, let's take a look. Now you see right here? He has a bus pass, which leads me to believe that he has no car, which means no income. And he's wearing a jersey, and he just asked me for $20, so we all know he does not play for the team. Now, let's pan up a little bit and take a look at this hat. We all know he is too damn old to be wearing a hat cocked to the side. Now, pan down with me for a little bit. You see right here? He's wearing jeans with a crease, which lets me know that he lives at home with his mama. Now, don't get me wrong. I want a man who loves his mother. I just don't want no mama's boy. That is a big difference. All right. Now let's look over at his wrist. That's a $1,000 watch, which is a frivolous and ignorant purchase when we all know he don't even have a car. Like, why would you do that? That's so crazy. All right, now, you see right here, this region right here? We all know he ain't seen no parts of the gym. I'm just saying. So, let me recap. I don't need a man with no job, living at home with his mama, and clearly hasn't been to the gym and just plain ignorant. This is not the man that I'm looking for. All right, now let's take a look at this guy, my favorite. Now, at first glimpse, you may think, oh, he's a nerd. No offense, but let's take a look deeper, shall we? Now, you can tell that he has gotten a fresh cut within the last 10 days. All right, all that means is that he is not balling where he's got to get a fresh cut every 4 days. He looks presentable and he takes enough stock in himself. He's busy, but he's not too busy for you. You know what I'm saying? All right, now you see right here, he's got a briefcase. Let's take a look. Can we do that? Okay. Now inside, you're gonna see files for work. Ooh, and some charts and some graphs and shit. Ooh, and there's outliers, which means that he reads. And ladies, I even overheard him saying he's rolling over his IRA. That is a no-brainer. He's well-spoken, he's educated, clearly he's in the gym, he's father material, and he's a gentleman. These are all of the things that I should be looking for in my own Obama.
I am telling you here, and you heard it here first, my name is Nefertari Taylor, and I am gonna find my own Obama.